Next is Dog's Life, not A Dog's Life. I constantly make that mistake. Played this once at my dad's then girlfriend's in 2005 for like 20 minutes and never thought about it again until I picked up a cheap copy in 2013. When I was thinking of the first lot of games I wanted to record for this show, this got on the list because I wanted a more lesser known 3D platformer to complement doing Spyro the Dragon. The balance of big and small name games is something I'm always thinking of. I can't exactly just start off this show with Mario 64, Chrono Trigger, Sonic 3 and Knuckles. I'd blow through all the big games early while I'm still getting used to making videos and being bad at it. Then if I ever get good, I'd have nothing left. On starting a new game, we get introduced to our main character, Jake. He loves chasing chickens, farting on butterflies and trying to woo the dog next door, Daisy, who is surprisingly not impressed by his farting prowess. Daisy goes around the corner and gets loaded into a van. Jake chases and gets in front, only to be stuck in himself. But when Jake's loaded in, the back door is left open. The kidnappers are Wayne and Dwayne. Dwayne is big and stupid, Wayne is a stereotypical nerd with a million allergies and a slight lisp. How those became nerd stereotypes I never got. Dwayne wants to play with the nice dogs, but Wayne thinks they're disgusting and full of diseases. The bumpy road bounces Jake's cage out the back. This starts me in the first area, the farmhouse in Clarksville. Jake shakes off his dizziness while trying to figure out how to save Daisy. Some kid shows up and challenges Jake to a race to the top of the hill. The game explains to me the controls. Pressing triangle puts me in smell-o-vision, a first-person view where I can see a pillar of light around the kid, meaning he has a bone. I can also jump. Smell-o-vision also allows me to see and collect scents of 4 different colours. Each area has 40 purple scents that get me a bone when all are collected. There are also 8 yellow and green, and 4 red scents. I go up the hill and talk to the kid, who brags to Jake about winning the race. He challenges Jake to another that ends up just being following him around to make sure I know how to walk. Jake tries to remember the name of the place the kidnapper said, and the kid gives Jake a bone, the game's main collectible. He also suggests practicing racing with Lopez the Chihuahua. However, you can't challenge other dogs until you've collected the correct smells. One last thing with bones, you have to manually pick them up to collect them, even if someone has already handed it to you. Bones raise your status and make you perform better when challenging other dogs. I pause the game to turn on subtitles only to learn that the game doesn't have any. Worthless game. This is where the game tells me that collecting all the green scents is what lets me race dogs. I go back up the hill and see a huge orange glow in the background. These spots I can dig at to collect another bone. I drop down to the farmhouse where the game tells me about being able to pick up objects in my mouth. I somehow manage to throw this ball through the hoop without even trying. I then get collecting the scents around the house. When I get close to the house, I start to hear a radio from inside. Throughout the game, you'll hear many ads by a Miss Peaches, advertising her new cat food and other cat-related stuff. Inside the barn, I have to move stacks of hay around so I can climb up for another bone. I then collect the final green scent in front of the house to race the Chihuahua. There's a trail of dog treats to show the route of the race. To win, I not only have to come first, I also have to have the most treats. It's really easy, I just have to go around the house, then around a tree on the hill, around the horses, and I win with 60 more treats from Lopez. Winning lets me play as him for a minute. Only thing to do with him is have him go through the flop into the house and grab a bone for me. If I want to play as him again, I can get up close and bark at him, but there's nothing else for him to do. I then start going up the hill behind the house for some more scents. Gets me up to 16 purples, then 3 more in the barn, then another yellow, and some more purples back on the hill I raced the kid to. 28 purples. Drop down the side near this waterfall to see more scents on platforms, but mess up the jump. I swim back to land where I can see the exits to 3 different areas, but of course I'm not done here. I find this guy with a guitar and pick up his footprint trail. This guy sounds like a human Big the Cat.
Oh man, what a bummer! My amplifier batteries are dead! Like, what am I supposed to do? Hey dog dude, bring me a battery and I like toss you a bone!
I get following his footprint trail, getting more purples and scents and another yellow on the way. I grab the battery from the front door of the house and take it back, but he still needs 3 more. I take the road back up this time, which lets me get the last of the yellow scents. This starts a pissing contest. I have to piss on the corners to mark the most amount of territory. The camera angle combined with Jake's slipperiness and difficulty turning can make this a bit of a pain. I get points for every full square I manage to make. The bigger the square, the bigger the points. I win by being the first of 26 points. It makes a bone fall in one of the dog bowls, letting you see that this game also had product placement by pedigree. I get 2 of the red scents by this tractor near the house and get the next battery nearby. 2 left. Back at the house once again, I jump up on the car and use it to get on the roof, getting me up to 38 purple scents. Then back to the tractor and use it to climb up to the last 2 red scents. Lopez shows up and I have to mimic his movements with the D-pad. Doing this also shows me a few tricks I can do with the D-pad. Left right down makes Jake fart. I mess it up somehow and have to collect the red scents again for a second go. I get it next time and make Jake shit on the floor. Left right left makes Jake shake himself off, and left right up makes him beg. Begging being the move I unlock for doing this. You'll also notice that Jake's head is drooping. That means he's hungry, which slows him down a lot. Thankfully there's loads of food either left on the floor or can be knocked out of boxes or bins. It just takes me friggin' forever to find some right here. While messing around, I find a 39th purple scent on that hill that I missed. You can also pick up Jake's turds in his mouth. The way you make him shit feels like pulling off a Mortal Kombat special move. In MK12, I went left right down to make Shao Kahn shit on the floor and pick it up in his mouth. He would still come across more impressive than he did in either MK9 or MK11. I finally pick up the 2 cents by Jake's cage right where I started. I also get onto the platforms behind that waterfall for a cent and the third battery that I take back to the guitar guy. There's one more area past the bridge near him I haven't visited yet. The kid is there with his sleeping granddad. He wants me to bark him awake, so I do. The kid then throws Jake under the bus by blaming him. This guy is Daisy's owner, and he's slightly aware that he hasn't seen her for a bit, but doesn't know she's been stolen. He asks to see some tricks, so the game shows me how to sit, stand and lie down. He compliments Jake, but Daisy will always be his dog, and he asks Jake to track her down. For doing this, I get a bone. This is also where the bone I won from the pissing contest spawned. The kennels are where I save the game. I mentioned the 3 exits to other areas before. In front of each one are 3 more purple cents, getting me all 50 and spawning another bone next to the kennel. Turns out that last battery was right behind the guitar guy next to the tree all along. He gives me the 8th bone of this area. Then I throw the ball through the hoop a couple more times for the 9th bone. That's everything collected in this area. From the old man's house I go right into the next area, Watermill. Right away there's a guy who can't find his axe while the game reiterates using smell-o-vision to follow his footprint trail. First thing I do is go into first person for all those cents. I first go around the outside of this fence, getting 2 red and 18 purple. Then jump over the fence to get up to 21 and the last 2 reds. Another copycat minigame, this time with the Dalmatian. Once again I mess up. While picking the red cents up again, I get the purple count up to 29. This one teaches me a second form of begging. Begging can be used to try and get food from people. Doesn't work if you stink, so don't go begging while holding shit in your mouth. I go up the hill behind the fence, getting purples up to 35. Then a bit of platforming up these steps, getting the count to 38. The missing axe is up here. I take it back and the guy gives me a bone. I push a haystack next to him up to the kennel and then do nothing with it. I just go swimming across the lake. Sometimes I really annoy myself watching these back. I reach the island in the middle and find a bone only for a goose to swoop down and take it. Instead of a yellow and green scent, this place has 8 orange and pink and all around this island. There's also another bone here I can dig up that won't get stolen. Getting all the oranges starts a tug of war with the Dalmatian. All I have to do is mash circle to win. Winning puts me in control of the Dalmatian. There's actually nothing the Dalmatian can do that Jake can't. Same size and same moveset. I then pick up the last pink scent. This one starts a pursuit minigame. I just have to catch the other dog before time runs out. Easy. I get her in time and spawn a bone at the kennel. That's 3 of them. I go behind the waterfall next to the island into a cave. I follow the winding path up and fail to jump the big gap to a small platform. I come back up as the Dalmatian, thinking it may jump better and easily make the jump. I pick up a bone without realising, but the Dalmatian can't go into smell-o-vision, so I have to come back. I make the jump as Jake, get the scent and slip off the edge. Turns out there's a purple scent going up this path too, getting me up to 40. Since Jake was getting tired and slowing down, I catch that goose with the Dalmatian and get the 4th bone. There also just happened to be another bone next to the tree on the island. I think it was the bone the Dalmatian picked up behind the waterfall. I cross to the other side of the lake to this hill and get sniffing some scents. By the time I reach the top, I have 47. At the top is a guy who has the exact same voice as Engine from Crash Bandicoot.
At last, they said it couldn't be done.
Basically, he's got his own made rocket and it's going to be the first homemade rocket to reach Pluto. This game came out before Pluto was fired for not being a good enough planet. He sets it off, breaks a skybox on the way up, and it explodes into many pieces around this area. He wants me to get the pieces for him. First piece is on the way back down the hill, second is on the island, third is up the hill towards the area I found the axe. I also find the last 3 purple cents around there too, making the bone spawn. That's 6. I finally climb up that haystack onto the house. The final piece of the rocket is in the fireplace. He rebuilds the rocket and launches it again. This time it doesn't come crashing down and he rewards me with the bone. Jake doesn't appreciate just one bone for all that work and growls at him, scaring him into giving him a second. I spend a while looking for the 9th bone, but this place only has 8. So I return to the farmhouse. I take the straight path forward from the old man's house to reach the big field. Right away I sniff a blue scent. These work a little differently in that only one is visible at first. You have to sniff one, then the next appears, and then get all 12 within the time limit. I give up after 3, stopping to dig up a bone. I go around the field getting 3 purple scents and all 8 yellow scents. This puts me in another pissing contest. First one's 25 points this time, another easy one. You have more time in control of a sheepdog than you do with the other 2 dogs before it. While messing around with it, I find a bone in the middle of these rocks and I throw it to Jake and give up control so I can grab it. I then get running all over this field for more scents. It's a bit hard to tell what's going on though with all the green scents signifying sheep. I get up to 22 purples before I pick up another bone near where I found the last one. I jump this fence, get purples up to 25 and talk to this farmer. He keeps getting attacked by birds whenever he tries fixing the scarecrow. I have to keep near him and scare away all the birds by barking. It doesn't take long for him to fix the scarecrow and he gives me a bone for it. I get 3 more purple scents and all 8 light blue scents around here. They start a digging race. There's a trail of digging points, I just have to dig all mine first. I have more than enough bones for this, so I get all 5 before the sheepdog can even start his 4th. This puts a bone next to the kennel. I get the 28th through 30th purples and restart the blue scent challenge. It involves jumping over the fence every couple of scents. The only tricky part is Jake himself being awkward sometimes when it comes to jumping. This puts another bone next to the kennel. I get 19 more purple scents running to and around the kennel, just missing one. I then pick up both the bones I won. I talk to the other farmer whose sheepdog refuses to round up the sheep, so he asks Jake to get her to do it. So I take control of her and round up every single sheep, one at a time. This is why the sheepdog has such a large time limit. So, be real with me, has there ever been a sheep rounding minigame that's actually fun? And I mean fun, not just tolerated. I know there's the video game Sheep, but that's the entire game, so that doesn't count, and even though I own that game, I don't actually know if it's fun yet. Once all the sheep are rounded up, I get another bone. The sheep all flee right after it gives up the bone. All that's left here is the final purple scent for the last bone in this area. That's 25 bones total. I then get back on the road I arrived here on and keep following it to the chicken farm. I pick up 4 purple scents and end up talking to one of the farmers. He offers me a reward for getting rid of the fox terrorizing his chickens. I jump onto the back of his truck for another purple scent and a bone. I run around in smell-o-vision until I have 11 purple scents, then I jump over the fence to deal with that fox. I give up on that in seconds and get back to scent collecting. I get up to 20 purples and 5 oranges before I find a spot to dig for the second bone here. Then I get to the last 3 oranges so I can play tug of war with the bulldog. I win and get control of it. I go inside a chicken coop to find some newspapers and pick one up. I run out of time and pick up another purple scent before I take back control of the bulldog. I have him take more papers from the other coops and give them to the farmer. He manages to piece together the article about the dog theft saying it has spread from Clarksville to Lake Minnewawa. The farmer gives me a bone for this. I start chasing the fox, picking up some more scents on the way. The chase does kind of expose an issue with the game's control in that it can be a pain to turn smoothly. It takes a couple of minutes, but I manage to catch it. The fox runs off and the farmer's thankful as his own foxhound disappeared, clearly also stolen. He gives me another bone. Back to scent collecting, I get up to 31 purples and 5 pink before I cross the water and get up to 40 purple. Around this cave entrance I get up to 47. The 48th is inside the farmer's house, the 49th is behind it. I then get the last 3 pinks. This puts me in a chase with the bulldog that's over in seconds to spawn a bone at the kennel. I grab it and find the blue scent on top of the chicken coop. The first 4 are all on coops and then the trail leads through the fence. It's another easy one, getting me another bone. Another bone can be found by knocking over the bin near the pickup truck. I then find the last purple scent behind a rock to make the last bone for this place appear. That's 33 total. Back to farmhouse and just next to the entrance to the big field is the entrance to the village houses. I grab one scent right from where I start and accidentally move into the centre. I head back and continue with the scent collection. Running around the houses and through all the gardens, I pick up 15 purple scents before I find a girl holding a bone. But she's stuck inside, so I'll have to deal with that later. I get 3 more when I find this kid in the playground. He tells me the kid inside is Mary Jane and that she's been grounded. He offers Jake a bone in exchange for getting a letter to her to cheer her up. Instead of grabbing the letter, I get up to 22 purples, mess with the gumball machine and talk to this woman next to the park. She wants me to find her baby's missing doll. I'd already pulled it out of the tunnel in the playground, so I just bring it back to her and she makes me throw the doll in the baby's face. She says their dog used to do that before she disappeared and she rewards me with a bone. Around the corner I find the violet scent. These function identically to the blue scents, being on a timer and only appearing one at a time. I get the first 6 behind all the houses, then 4 in the garden, but then can't find the next one and run out of time. On my way back to the first one I get 2 more purples. At the last second I get the last 2 in the next garden. A bone appears next to the kennel. 2 more purples leave in that garden and I grab that bone. In the back garden next door, I knock over a bin for another bone. Through the next 2 gardens, I get up to 35 purple scents. I talk to this postman who can't do his delivery thanks to a psychotic terrier. I use my bike to lure the terrier towards the garage, open the door, grab some more purple scents, and shut the dog in. The postman can now do his job and gives me a bone as thanks. Back to scent collecting. I get up to 42 purple scents, 7 green scents, and dig up another bone. I then collect the last green scent for a race with the terrier. It's another very easy track, but Jake's awkward collision and the way he interacts with scenery does cause me a couple issues. When controlling the terrier, I find out it belongs to Mary Jane's mother. He gets let inside, which gets me access to Mary Jane. So I finally grab that letter and have the terrier take it in. Mary Jane gets the letter and she's very easily impressed.
Dear Mary Jane, wow, this is so cool!
She gives the terrier a bone to hand over to me. I go around the corner to another garden, gain up to 49 purple scents and all 8 light blue scents. I have a very easy digging race with a terrier where I dig all 6 holes in the time it takes a terrier to dig up just 3. That's another bone by the kennel. I then take control of the terrier to squeeze into the greenhouse and dig up another bone. I search a little and find the last purple scent in a garden I'd already been in to spawn the last bone for this area. Getting the 2 from the kennel brings me up to 42 total. Now I can deal with the centre. I run around the beginning and up this hill collecting scents. Then across a bridge and down the stairs back to where I started. This gets me 27 purple scents and 1 green. I talk to this kid who offers to let Jake join his gang in exchange for some eggs. They say if I bring enough eggs, I'll get to sneak into one of the shops for a snack. I get back to picking up scents, gain 30 purple and 5 green before I talk to the owner of said shop who threatens to shoot Jake if he doesn't go away. I go into the tunnel next to him that leads to some back gardens. I get up to 34 purple scents and start the violet scents, but run out of time. From there I get up to 38 purples, 2 orange and all 8 green. This puts me in a race with a Doberman. This leads back into the gardens and through the tunnel next to the shop, then up the hill and over the bridge and then down. And despite me having over 70 treats collected, because the Doberman snuck past the finish line first when I turned too hard, he wins despite having only 4 trees. I get another purple scent in the shop next to the finish line and a 40th while I'm getting the greens again. But it happens again, Jake just suddenly gets dizzy and runs right into the shop for the Doberman to steal the win. This time there was an even bigger difference between our scores. Next time I win and have Jake do a celebratory head spin. I get control of the Doberman but don't figure out what to do with it yet. So I get going back to the gardens where I get 1 more purple, 3 more orange scents and dig up a bone, then 2 more purple in the back of this shop. I try the violet scents but once again get lost and run out of time. On my way back to try again I get the 44th purple scent. It's easy to get lost doing this one because there's so many bright purple scents surrounding NPCs and there's cars passing by sometimes blocking your view. After failing twice more I head towards a train only for a catcher from the pound to spot me. He sends his own dog after me that I have to avoid until it gets tired. I get caught on the edge of this hill because the camera angle tricks me into thinking I was running towards a slope. I get caught but Jake gets his freedom by bribing the dog with a bone. Now the dog catcher isn't a problem. That's the thing with these dog catchers, even if you get caught you can still get past them from now on. You just have to spend a few extra seconds finding and digging your lost bone back up, kind of a pointless mechanic. My bone was buried by the train station and no one stops me from digging it back up. You may have noticed Jake's legs and belly being covered in dirt, well here I can get him a wash. It doesn't last long but it does make people want to feed me more often when I beg since I sink less. Inside the supermarket, the shopkeeper teases me by offering a bone, and then telling me I can't have one. In here I can get tins of pedigree dog food from the vending machine where I learn that Jake just eats the entire tin. Some foods can mess with Jake's stomach and have him gone uncontrollably farting for a bit. I take control of the Doberman and have him scare the shopkeeper into handing over the bone. I've been pissing about in here for 15 minutes already, and that's only my second bone. I said I get annoyed watching myself back. 2 more purple scents near the kennel. Yeah, the scents can be a huge pain. They're like a more annoying version of the figments from Psychonauts, only you're stuck in the first person with a smaller view and the scents themselves have quite a small draw distance sometimes. I'm just going to assume that there's 100% overlap between the audiences of Dog's Life and Psychonauts for the comparison to make sense. I finally finished the violet scents after a million attempts. They're so hidden and a couple don't show up on screen until you're right up in front of them, which is why it's a huge pain in the ass. That puts the bone by the kennel. Half an hour in this small place of 3 bones. I pick up a basket behind those kids who asked me for eggs a million years ago and break through this spot in the fence in the back garden. Breaking the fence is easier said than done. Jake's awkward and so is the camera angle, so line yourself upright and getting the right speed is harder than it looks. I pick up the chicken in this garden and terrorise it to make it lay eggs in fear. Also while I'm in here I find the last few purple scents for another bone by the kennel. I knock over the bin here for another bone. After a tedious repetition of making the chicken lay eggs and putting them in the basket, including many times where Jake just launches the egg and breaks it, I have all 6. I take the basket to the kids who have an egg of the guy who owns the meat shop. While he's distracted I sneak in and grab a bone, and then return to the garden and pick up the last 2 orange scents. The resulting tug of war with the Doberman is over in seconds and that's another bone by the kennel. That's this place and Clarksville as a whole fully completed, 49 bones in total. I go past the dog catcher and hop on the train. After the train leaves we get a cutscene with Wayne and Dwayne. Dwayne gets a phone call that turns out to be Miss Peaches from the radio. She's happy to hear that they've got her some Clarksville dogs, but he's furious to find they still haven't got any mountain dogs from Lake Minnewawa. Turns out they haven't gone there yet because Dwayne can't read the map. Turns out it's just around the corner. The train takes Jake to the Lake Minnewawa cafe. As soon as Jake gets off the train, it's scent collecting time. I get 4 purples before talking to this crying girl. Some boy stole her coat to dress their snowman with. I put it on my to-do list and get back to sniffing. I get 12 purples and 1 light blue before the cafe's waiter asks me to deal with pigeons that are pestering the customers. But first, smell-o-vision. I circle around the outside of the cafe, getting the purple count up to 19 before I knock over a bin for my first bone here. After circling around, I go back to the car park where I get 22 purple and 7 light blue, then up the stairs by the train for the 23rd purple. Then it's inside the cafe itself for 5 more purples. You can mess with the slot machine in here for food, but Jake can also get stuck on the corner of it and start freaking out. With most of the cafe done except for the waiter's request, I start heading up the snowy hill for more scents. I get up to 33 purples and find a spot to dig for a bone. And further up the hill there's another bone just laying there for me to grab. On my way back I find the last light blue scent for a digging race. Even with me forgetting to dig the first spot and accidentally giving the other dog a head start, I still dig up all 7 spots before it can do 5. I can now control the boxer. Only the boxer can deal with the pigeons bothering the cafe. I have to bark them away, then chase them and keep barking until they've left completely. This gets me another bone. The boxer gets nothing for doing the work. I try inspecting this cave for scents, but it takes me to a new area for ski slope. Later, I try running up this road, which gets me 2 more purple scents, but takes me to the high street. I said later. I head down to the far back part of this area on the ice, where I finally shooed away the pigeons for good. I get 4 green scents, up to 39 purple, and set off the violet scent hunt. These are all on the ice, which makes movement a nightmare. I manage to find 11, but time runs out before I can find the last one. I leave it for now and get up to 41 purples and the last 4 greens. Well, after slipping past the last one excruciatingly slowly a few times. This gets me a race with the boxer around the cafe and on the ice. Thanks to the annoying ice physics, the boxer manages to get far more points than any other opponent so far. It then goes through the car park and past the train station and makes its way back to the cafe where I win and get the bone by the kennel. Near the train tracks is where I find the last lot of purple scents for another bone in that dog bowl. I have another go at the violet scents but run out of time before even picking up a second one. It takes a couple more tries and it isn't fun thanks to how much the ice physics can slow you down, but I finally get it and that bowl gets a third bone in it. I pick them all up and that's 56 bones. All that's left is a little girl's coat, but the coat actually isn't in this area. This is the first time a bone requires travelling between two different areas. So I choose the ski slope as the next area I'm going to visit, following the footprint trail from the girl. For whatever reason, I'm ignoring all the scents around me as I go up to the ski lift and talk to this guy outside it. The wind takes his hat and puts it on one of the seats going up. It then blows off the seat to the top of this mountain. I keep following the footprints at the slope, but they run out and I get confused. I accidentally sniffed Hat Man and overrode the girl's footprints with his. I go down the slope, picking up a single purple scent on the way. Instead, I just find the coat in this cabin a little up the slope. I give it back to the girl, but now she wants me to find her missing dog. She has me follow her to where she found his collar. She says after she found the collar, a big red truck could be seen driving away. Clearly, he's been kidnapped too. Now I have the dog catcher after me again. This one's weird. To avoid the dog catcher, I just have to stay put. He can't reach me in time and I'm somehow escaped him without even moving. I talk to the girl again and she gives me the last bone of this area. Now I try to explore the ski slope. Right away, smell-o-vision around this house next to the start and along the fence next to it gets me up to 14 purple scents. At the end of the fence is a stone-sounding 10-year-old who dares me to hit him with exactly 3 snowballs, and next to them is a spot I can dig up a bone from. I get picking snowballs up and throwing them at the kid. 3 hits gets me a bone. Then I get 2 more purple scents on my way to the bottom of the ski lift. As I head up, I knock a skier over and shit on him. You've got her. Around the cabin I found the coat, I get up to 19 purples. I head up into the left and get that total up to 25. Further up the top of the slope is 2 more purples and I cause a huge pileup. There's also a carrot here. Then at the cafe at the top, I get that total up to 31. I swap out my carrot for a huge hat. This lets me know that this place will definitely have a bone rewarded for building a snowman. I wear the hat to the guy who lost his just to taunt him a little. I find another purple scent on the way back up. Left from the cafe, I find a 33rd purple scent and some kids with a snowman. Next to them is a kid who's struggling with her own snowman. She's competing with the other kids over who can build a better snowman, so she's going to cheat and get outside help. She makes me a snowball that I then have to roll until it's big enough to be the head. Next, she just asks for the rest of the parts. I grab the carrot left at the cafe and give it to her for the nose. I pick up 1 more purple scent on the way back to the hat I launched in the middle of the ski slope. After handing that over to her, I head towards the nearby hut, grabbing purple scent 35 on the way. Inside there's another bone for me to pick up. I can also pick up the coals from the fireplace to give to her for buttons and eyes. I have to do this a total of 5 times. During this, I actually stopped to listen in on one of Miss Peach's interviews on the radio. It's basically an excuse to have as many innuendos using the word pussy as they like.
I'll be back soon with an announcement that will make your personal pussy purr with pleasure.
Basically a lot of that. Once I've given the kid the 5th bit of coal, there's just the arms left. Instead I go over to the left to get the 4 red scents. It's another copycat minigame to learn another beg move. Near the hut I find the first twig on the floor and give it to the girl. The second is right next to where I found the first. The other kids are impressed by her snowman and say she wins the contest. I get a bone for this, which is far more important than some kid's self-esteem. I head downwards from here, getting another purple and slide down the slope for 6 green scents. I also miss an orange one near the bottom. I managed to grab that one but I can't run up the slope any further. Just to the right is a trail of scents that gets me up to 48 purples and 7 oranges. Then there's this little icy patch with the last 2 green scents and last orange. I get the 2 missing greens first for a race. The Vimarana gets the first few treats but then I take the lead right away. This one goes across the cafe at the top and all the way down the ski slope, ending at the bottom of the lift. As I take control of the Vimarana, Jake tells me that it's good at jumping. This lets me climb up the mountain where the guy's hat is. I screw up the first time and just leave it for now while I get the last orange scent. I win the tug of war for a bone near the kennel. Jake's exhausted so I slowly limp my way to the bone for some energy. I take control of the Vimarana again and this time make the jump to the top of the mountain for the guy's hat. Once again, despite both dogs being in front of him, only Jake gets a bone. And then not far from there are the last 2 purple scents, getting me the last bone in this area. I return to the cafe and go up the road again to the high road. I start off by roaming the road for cents. This gets me 17 purple cents, plus an 18th I miss on the way back to the beginning to talk to this kid. His RC helicopter landed on top of one of the buildings and it's broken, so he can't make it fly back. I go around the back of said building and up the ramp to pick up 2 blue cents and get up to 23 purple. Halfway up, I can go inside to talk to an old guy who's trying to call a relay station, but the phone lines are down and his radio won't transmit. Doesn't help that he beats the shit out of his equipment. What's the obvious solution? Ask a passing dog to fix the antenna. I go back down and keep picking up cents behind these buildings. In a short amount of time, I get up to 32 purple, 7 yellow, and all 8 light blue. I'm in another digging contest against a husky. 8 to dig this time and I get them all by the time the husky has only done 4. I leave controlling the husky for now and get back to my cent collected. There's one last purple behind these buildings. I get out front and get my purples up to 37 as I enter this hotel and get a wash. I go up the ramp out the front door where I can pick up these pigeon feeds. I picked up 2 more purple cents on the way and get the 40th inside the building. Continuing up the ramp, I get 2 more purples, jump onto the roof and slide right off. I cross the road and check behind the big building there for the 43rd purple cent and the first violet cent. Of course I can't find them all first try and it's for the same reason as every other time. I only manage 8 of them. I try again after eating so I can run faster. I manage to find 2 more of the violet cents on the road but still run out of time. As someone who usually likes collecting pointless shit in games, I really hate the violet cents. Before I try again, I find 2 more purple cents in this section. Turns out the last 2 violet cents I was looking for are off to the side from where I started. You'd never know because normally you're pointed towards a different cent, and by the time you've reached that one, you're too far away for those last 2 to show up on screen. I grab my new bone and take control of the husky again. The husky can stand on that roof without slipping off. With it, I cross to the other side and can send this kid his helicopter, gain me another bone. I go into the cabin at the cable car station and find this area's 3rd bone. I go back behind the hotel and find the last yellow cent. For this pissing contest, I have to be the first of 29 points. Just as easy as the others. Another bone appears at the kennel. At the spot I found that last yellow, I also find 4 more purples, just one left. Hidden away behind the cable car station is another bone to dig up, then pick up the one I won for pissing. Up the ramp at the hotel where I found the pigeon feed, and knock over a bin for another bone, just 2 left here. I grab the pigeon feed and get in the cable car to go to the mountaintop area. I ignore everything else here and just take the feed up the mountain to the antenna. This gets all the pigeons off it and makes the radio work again. I return to the high road and talk to the old guy for my bone, just the last purple cent left. No lie, it alone takes another 20 minutes to find. In the second floor of the building with the pigeon feed, I have to jump onto this stack of boxes for the last cent. This makes the final bone here appear at the kennel, getting my bone total to 72. I then go back to the mountaintop. I get 4 purple cents and 2 red cents. Right by the cable car is the operator trapped behind the door to his own cabin. There's a box blocking the door, so I move it to free him. The guy's brother went climbing and is now missing. When he's safe, I'll get a bone. But he does also give me one for freeing him. I check out the cabin for another red and yellow cent. I go to the right of the cable car to my 5th purple cent, but then I take the left path, the way towards the antenna. I get my purple count up to 11 and all 8 pink cents. I have to chase down the Mastiff to be able to control it. He barely dodges me seconds in, but doesn't last much longer. Once again, the new dog is saved for later when I have some idea of what it's used for. Heading up the slope from where the game put me, I find a blue cent but none of the others on the way to the antenna. I do find a bone I can dig up behind the antenna though. While I'm up here, I get up to 16 purple and all 8 yellow cents. This time the pissing contest has the pattern of a spiderweb and I have to get to 49 points. Slightly more complex, but still easy. I'm just too good at pissing and get a bone by the kennel. On my way back down the slope, I get the easiest 12 blue cents so far, getting a second bone by the kennel. I return to the section where I got the last red cent and pick up 4 more purples. I also pick up a 21st that I missed before I get back to the kennel and grab the bones I won. I then take the slope directly across from the cable car for 3 more purples. Then it's down to the right of the cable car, getting 4 more before I cross a bridge. I take a path downwards, crossing a tree to get even further down and getting up to 37 purples before I pick up another bone. On the way back up, my purple count goes up to 41. Going up, I get more purples, but I can't cross this gap. This is where the Mastiff comes in. He's strong enough to pull on this log to make a bridge across the gap. Crossing the log lets me get the last few purple cents and the bone by the kennel. That's 79 bones total. There is still the one for saving that guy's brother, but it can't be done in this place alone. So I cross the log again and go through this cave to reach the mountainside. This place has endlessly falling boulders. At the beginning I get 6 purple cents. Getting hit by a boulder simply starts you at the beginning of the area. I get running up the mountain, dodging boulders and picking up cents. I climb up the first right I can and get up to 18 purple cents before digging up a bone. I climb up a few more steps, getting my count up to 28 and a second bone just lying in the snow. The climb continues, I get more cents and dig up a third bone. Why couldn't the high road have been this generous? I get a 32nd cent but fail to jump the gap and fall. I get it next time and manage to grab 2 more cents before a boulder flattens me. I get back up and keep moving while very narrowly avoiding more boulders. It puts me in a safer area, still with boulders but also with the kennel and many more cents. I get up to 46 purple, 2 orange, 3 light blue, and all 4 red scents. Another copycat minigame, this time with the St. Bernard to get another form of begging. I mess it up first time. Before trying again, I get up to 7 light blue and all 8 orange scents. I win the tug of war to gain control of the St. Bernard. I take him up the slope and find the missing brother. He has a jug of water around his neck for him to drink. He draws a map to his current location on his hat for Jake to give to the operator. But first there's a bone behind that hat. I then grab the remaining 4 purple scents to spawn a bone at the kennel, but then I get hit by a boulder and have to climb back up. I grab the bone, then the final light blue scent. Digging minigame, 9 holes, finish all 9 while the St. Bernard only does 5, get bone from kennel, 85 total. Then he's just doing the copycat minigame right to learn the new beg. This area was surprisingly quick. I give the operator his brother's hat so he knows where to find him. His brother gets a rescue helicopter and I get a bone. That's the mountaintop finish too. He also mentions dogcatchers shipping caught dogs off to Boom City. I return to the high road and take the road itself to the opposite side where I enter from the cafe, taking me to the hotel. This is the final area in Lake Minnewawa. As usual, getting scents comes first. I get purples, on this spiked mohawk wig, then run around the area getting my purple scent count up to 18 before I find a bone lying by the side of the hotel. Then circling around the hotel some more, I get the count up to 23 and kick off the blue scents. Failed up this hill, down the road, but after 8 I can't find the next one and a little cutscene kicks me out of it as I enter the building. The guy won't let me pass until I find his dog. From there it's back to scent collecting. Up to 29 in front of the hotel, then up to 38 around this nearby house across the road. This house also has a bone I can get by knocking down the bin behind it. I go through the front door of the hotel for the 39th purple scent and talk to this guy at a piano. I give him his wig and he asks me to find the rest. I go up the hill where the blue scent took me to get up to 43 purple, 2 yellow and 4 pink before I dig up a bone here. Back to sniffing and I get up to 44 purple, 7 yellow and all 8 pink. This starts off a chase with a miniature pincher that lasts maybe 3 seconds. I take control and take her to her owner who wants her to get rid of some rats. The rats are organised though and Jake doesn't think she can handle them. I have to chase them all around this room, pick them up and throw them into the bin. I have over 400 seconds as this dog though, so at least the time limit is generous. The actual hard part is the throw working right. Sometimes he'll go right in, and sometimes he'll just refuse and crash into the side of the bin. Once I've thrown them all in, her owner gives her a bone that Jake then taxes her for. Now the owner will let Jake in where I can get 2 more purple scents from the kitchen. Outside the door is a second wig to get to the piano player. The third is right in front of the front door. The last wig is across the road from the hotel. On giving it to him, he gives me a bone. I go back up the hill since the catch game interrupted my collecting. I get another purple scent and the last yellow scent. For this pissing contest I have to be the first of 62 points. The area for this one is so big, it might actually be the easiest one so far since the other dog barely gets to mark my territory. That's a bone by the kennel. Then behind the blue scent is 2 more purples, just one left. Next I go and complete the blue scent chase. It's just a full lap around the hotel. A second bone in the ball. The last purple scent is also around here. I pick up all 3 bones by the kennel, getting my total to 95. That's all of Lake Minnewawa complete. So I return to the cafe. I take the bridge over the train to the other side to get a ride to Boom City. We get another scene with Wayne and Dwayne. Wayne complains about his allergies and Dwayne gets another call from Miss Peaches. After checking that they did get some mountain dogs for her, she tells him to deliver them to the Boom City dog pound. Dwayne asks if she's going to hurt the dogs, and while she doesn't say no, her response doesn't inspire much confidence. Dwayne thinks she could use some therapy. After that, Jake arrives at the Boom City station. Smell-o-vision first, I get 6 purple scents from the surrounding area before I talk to this policeman.
Hey Pooch, how's about you and me track down the sleeping bandit? He's a famous robber. I hate that punk.
If you've ever wanted to hear a man sound like he's trying to seduce a dog, this is a game for you. His own dog lost his sense of smell when the bandit doused him in perfume. Of course that smell is still on the dog and the bandit's bag, so I can use it to track the bandit down. But first, collecting. I go down the street and around these warehouses, getting to 16 purple scents and all 8 yellows. For this pissing game I have only to get 18 points. There's a few small sections and a huge one worth loads of points. I never lose a piss game. Now I can control the Alsatian. I leave it for now and get back to my sniffing. Climbing up the warehouse gets me one more purple but I can't get any higher. I go the other way from the station and build up to 22 purple and all 8 pink scents for the catch game. I catch the Alsatian in a couple seconds to make a bone appear at the kennel. I grab it and run around this section to get up to 29 purple scents before I dig up another bone by the tree. Then the last few around here get that total to 34, then a 35th on the way out. I was climbing up these stairs outside this building when getting the last pink scent moved me away, so I start climbing up them again. I get a purple scent on the way up and enter the building. I get one more on the way to this bedroom containing a bone. Also...
Hello, 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 and welcome to Talking Pussy, here on Boom City's CATS radio, the station dedicated to pretty pussies everywhere.
That's about 70% of this game's humour. The rest are really bad one-liners from Jake that I haven't played because they aren't worth the effort. He's interviewing Miss Peaches on how she's going to be unveiling a new cat food soon. I think most of you will probably guess where that's going. There's two more scents in this room. I stayed in here listening to the rest of this broadcast. I'm not going to play every single pussy pun. The interview's about 15 minutes long, no joke. We don't have all day. But there is this one.
Their pussies are my children, and all my children are pussies.
I finally get going to view the end of this apartment for the 40th purple scent and the blue scent. They lead out the apartment, down the fire escape and into the garden where the kennel is. I actually complete a blue scent on my first try, and since the last one is right next to the kennel where the bone spawns, it's also a very generous one. I finally decide to follow the sleeping bandit's scent and it just leads me back to the warehouses. The footprints stop at a closed door. I fail to climb it once again and give up. Instead, I forgot to try smell-o-vision next to the cop's dog, getting me four more purple scents. I finally remember the Alsatian and try climbing with that. He jumps further than Jake, which is actually a problem at first, since he can jump over the boxes I need to climb up. And since other dogs can't go into smell-o-vision, I'm stuck in this awful fixed camera that just makes things more frustrating. It's way too easy to make it jump off when you're just trying to turn. I turned out to be missing something anyway. This switchable the crate that lowers a window to create a platform, so I could climb this as Jake all along. With the window open, I can get inside the warehouse where I have to pull some crates to create a bridge to cross to the other side. I follow this path around to the end warehouse to find the sleeping bandit. I sneak up behind him and steal his mask. I have a split second to react before he pulls out a gun and fucking shoots me. The worst part of having to repeat this is it also resets the crates, but then it turns out you can make the jump without them, so there's no point. I swipe the mask again and this time I sneak off so I don't wake him up. I reach the bottom of the warehouse and try to open the door, but Jake's too tired. So I take the long way back and hand the mask over to the cop. Jake takes the cop back to the warehouse, but that door's still locked on the inside, so I send the Alsatian in to do it. Have to do the crates this time. The cop gives me the bone and tells me he has an accomplice, but he isn't in this area, that's for later. He leaves me to pick up my 100th bone. I go back into the room with the crates as I need them to reach another bone in one of the corners. I head back to the train station and jump across the tracks to find three more purple scents hidden behind crates. The last three are found by climbing the crates onto the roof. It spawns the last bone for this place next to the kennel. Total bones is now 102. Then I just head down the street to go to the park. First thing I want to bring up about the park is that its music track is actually named Porno for some reason. First I grab two purple scents and jump a fence to grab a music sheet. I run into the central park where I get up to six purple, three light blue and dig up the first bone here. I find another music sheet behind a nearby tree and drop it where I threw the first one when digging up that bone, just so I know they're all in the same place. Back to scent hunting. I get to 7 purple, 4 light blue, 2 red and all 8 pinks. This time I'm catching a greyhound and it goes just as quick as the rest. The greyhound is surrounding up kittens and dropping them off in this woman's living room. There's 2 on her side of the street and 3 on the other. Not as simple as dropping them all off though, they'll constantly walk towards the door to escape so you have to keep them all in as well. I end up running out of greyhound time the exact second I drop off the final kitten. Even though I never spoke to this woman as Jake, she knows it was thanks to him and gives me a bone. You can't pick up these cats once they're returned, they'll bite Jake on the nose. I leave the house and get back to scent collecting. Back towards the park, I get up to 5 light blue and 18 purple before digging up a bone in the corner. From there, I get 5 more purples before running into another guitar guy who lost all his music sheets. I already know where 2 of them are. I get up to 28 purple and 6 light blue as I pass a sheet and give it to the guitar guy. Every time you give him a sheet, he plays a new bit of music. I hand him over one of the ones I found earlier, followed by the other one I left there. I then grab the last 2 cents nearby. One more copycat game to learn another form of begging. That's all forms of begging learned, meaning I have also collected every red cent in the game. I find another sheet in the park, get the 7th light blue cent and hand it over. The two new players this time starts off very similar to Sweet Home Alabama. I get my purple count up to 35 and grab the last sheet nearby. I drop it off and I get a bone from him. I then collect the last light blue scent in the park for a digging race. 10 digging spots, I get my 10 done before the greyhound can do 7, bone by the kennel. It's back to roaming the perimeter next. I get up to 39 purple scents before I grab the bone at the kennel. Then up to 42 before I find a bin to knock over for another bone. Then up to 44 before I jump back in the park for a 45th. I've circled the entire area but I'm still missing 5. 46th is in another corner of the park, 47th I missed on the pavement. While searching, I pass the dog pound where the dog catcher spotches me. Spotches. While searching, I pass the dog pound where the dog catcher spots me. I try jumping the park fence, but another smaller fence blocks me and lets the Doberman catch me. So I'm bribing the dog with another bone. It's right behind me and I dig it back up. The 48th purple scent is to the right of the catcher. I accidentally run into the dog pound which loads up the final area of the game. The catcher follows me in but gets distracted when Wayne and Dwayne arrive. Dwayne states his plan to open a hypoallergenic dog grooming parlour so people like Wayne can play with dogs without having to suffer their allergies. When talking to the catcher, we learn that Miss Peaches wants a clean Clarksville dog to be the first in the machine. The two take their delivery in and I'm shown a few caged dogs, and some keys to those cages. Well, they're gonna have to wait because I didn't mean to come here this early. Back to the park. The last two purple scents were hidden in the purple cloud that's always coming out of the guitar guy. That's pretty shitty. But now I can get the last bone for this place. 109 total. Just one more place to visit before I return to the pound. Next to the kennel is the entrance to the last normal level of the game, Boom City Center. Right away I start my final scent collection. It can be a bit of a pain on this road as cars can park in the same spot as a scent, leaving you unable to pick it up until said car moves its arse. As I run down the street and around the left, I grab 13 purples and the last 8 orange scents in the game. I win the final tug of war against another greyhound and gain control. Back to Jake, I knock over a nearby bin for a bone. Then back to scent collecting. I go around the right turn and get up to 23 purples and all 8 green scents. One last race. This one has me weaving between posts, which with Jake's turn in makes this one of the most terrifying moments of any video game. For the final race, I manage to grab all 103 treats and leave the opponent with nothing. Bone by the kennel. From where the race finished, I get back to collecting and get my total of purple scents up to 44. You can take this window cleaner's lift up to a bedroom and jump in through the window. There's nothing to do in here, so I leave the owners a little gift on their bed for wasting my time. I go up these stairs by the beginning to find the sleeping bandit's partner, wondering where the other is. I get 2 more purple scents as I approach him, only for him to shoot me. Across the road from those stairs is another lift to a bedroom containing the violet scent. Once again, this one can be a pain thanks to the cars blocking your view, and there is a point you have to know one is behind this fence you can break. I take another lift up into another bedroom for the 9th of 12, but then get lost and fail when I enter a diner nearby and set off a dog catcher. I don't get caught this time thanks to a load of straight roads and a more agreeable camera angle. I head back to the diner where I find a bone to the right of the door. To the left is the kennel where I can grab the bone I won for the race. Right outside the door is a guy to talk to. He lost all his money playing cards with someone inside. He knows the other player cheated but just doesn't know how. If I go into the back I can see the winner scamming another guy. All I have to do is walk up behind him to swipe the extra deck of cards he was hiding. When his victim calls him out, the scammer avoids a punch in the face by offering him a free drink, while Jake takes the money the guy outside lost and gives it back to him. He gives me a bone. I hang out underneath the other bandit and keep walking and barking to lure him away from his bag. I then take the chance to run up and swipe it. I hand it over to the policeman from the station. He arrests the bandit and gives me another bone. With the bandit out of the way, I can grab the final 4 purple scents in the game that he was blocking me from. That's another bone at the kennel. Time for another go at the violet scents. After getting back up to 9 cents, the 10th is further down and in the next bedroom. I end up failing though because Jake just refuses to jump back through the window. I get it a couple more attempts later. 2 more will buy another room out of the way around the corner. I'm just so happy I never have to deal with these scents again. Or any even, these were the final scents in the game. I head over to the kennel to grab the 2 bones to finish off this place. 116 total, just the dog pound left. First I have to free these dogs using the keys that are lying around everywhere. Within a few seconds I get caught by the catcher's dog. Here it doesn't take a bone from me, it just puts me back at the beginning. I then spend ages just running around and I don't know what I'm doing here. I pass the keys many times but I just don't pick them up. I even run right up to the immobile dog catcher calling the scenery to bark at him and get myself caught again. I finally think to grab the first key but get caught at the same time. Next time I once again grab the key by the trees and manage to free the Dalmatian. I then think I'm going to pick up another key but it turns out to be a hole Jake's up to dig and I get caught again. By the way, you have to free all the dogs in one go. Since I got caught, the Dalmatian is back in the cage. I free the Dalmatian again this time and by a tree pick up a bone, almost getting myself caught. I grab the key in the front of the pound but Jake hesitates to jump down and gets me caught. I get to keep the bone at least. Next time I get the key in front of the house and free the Dalmatian again, so it looks like the keys aren't for a specific cage, you open them in order. I grab the second key outside the middle fence and use it to free the next dog. Then the one by the trees frees the Mastiff. The dog catcher gives up on his job after this failure and decides to pursue his true passion of making video games instead. Banjo-Tooie beat to that joke 3 years earlier and did it better. The Doberman stays behind though to guard the entrance to Miss Peaches. There's 5 bones on top of the cages, then 2 more to dig up. One by the fence and the one I got caught while digging earlier. I get closer to the house and scare off the Doberman with my huge bone total. You need at least 90 bones to beat the game. There's one last bone in the bin behind the house. That's all 125 bones of the game and every single collectible obtained. All that's left is to enter the house. For the finale, we first see Miss Peaches telling Wayne and Dwayne that they've done well despite their idiocy. She particularly likes Daisy, finding her perfect for a new machine. This is where she just comes out and says that she wants good dogs for a machine to cut them up into cat food and that Daisy is the one she wants to test it on. Dwayne's a bit behind and asks if she's going to hurt the dog and Miss Peaches just laughs in his face. When I gain control, I press this button to open the door to the machine. Daisy's on a conveyor belt, just lying there not seeming to get what's going on. I can't find the bone to turn off the machine in time and she gets grinded up into cat food. They got a lot of tins of food out of that one dog. Try again. The issue was I run right past the first ramp and wasted time. I go down and press the first button to turn that part off. Then I run over to where I failed last time and turn off one of the grinders, followed by the other one next to it. I run around the corner and down another ramp to pull this lever that turns off the crushers, then across another catwalk to turn off the next set. I then have to climb up these boxes, but I lose a shitload of time when arsehole Jake refuses to jump down where he's supposed to, and Daisy gets sawed to death. Between this and the blood red hell sky outside, was anyone expecting the end of the farting dog game to get this dark? Next time Jake does as he's told and I can turn off the saws. I run along the next catwalk to turn off some more saws. It's then up a ramp and along one last long catwalk to the final part. There's a spanner that keeps spawning by this machine. I just have to throw three in to jam it and shut off the machine, beating the game. Daisy gets free and stopping her from getting minced has her into Jake now, but Miss Peaches interrupts with a shotgun, intending to march them into the machine. Jake instead just turns around and farts. The smell is so bad, Miss Peaches falls over the railing and onto the conveyor below. It traps Miss Peaches in a giant novelty tin and feeds her through the machine.
Slicing, dicing, mashing. Miss Peaches is cat food.
Well, Jake, you just murdered a woman and sold her remains to a radio audience. That's pretty hardcore. How about that ending cutscene?
Well, that's it, I guess. The story of a dog's life. My old friends all threw me a swell homecoming party back in Clarksville. Gramps wrote a book while I was gone, the story of his life, but the lawyers say he has to change the title. My old guitar-playing buddy finally made it big with a smash hit record, which I guess you probably own. Wayne and Dwayne opened a hypoallergenic dog grooming parlor. Now that Wayne's allergy is gone, he likes nothing better than to hang around with his doggy pals and have a great time. And as for me and Daisy, oh yes, now she is mine.
Well, that last statement sounded menacing. Don't you love when a game's ending is just the main character rapid-firing, this is what happened to everyone over complete silence? Dog's Life can be enjoyed, and the game had a lot of potential, but there were some glaring issues, namely the control. Jake is just a nightmare sometimes. He can't turn, he gets stuck on corners easily, he'll refuse to just do simple jumps he shouldn't struggle with. Plus the smell-vision mechanic means you're stuck spending most of the game in first person with a grey filter over everything. Plus the mechanic of needing food or a slow to a crawl just isn't enjoyable. It makes a search for some food more annoying than it needed to be. This is the kind of game that needed a sequel or remake to iron out the problems, but it's also the kind of game that would never be successful enough to justify one being made, and that's a shame. I looked at my old ranking from 2018 and I actually had this listed above Orphan, but I can't say I believe the same now. I would say it belongs in that enjoyable but flawed section of the ranking I have going on. If this game does look interesting to you, it is incredibly cheap so you wouldn't be losing too much money if you try it out. Just be prepared to some frustrating controls.